wisconsingarden.com. Back a few years ago when we just started and we were wisconsingarden.net, we did about 300 videos, and in the very early ones, some of our visitors said that they had difficulty understanding what I was saying, hearing. And so Rick, as his learning curve has improved and his talents have increased, decided that he would go back and redo them to enhance their quality. This is one of those videos. We hope you enjoy it. Give us a thumbs up if you've learned something and can appreciate them. Bye. Good morning. This is Lynn from wisconsingarden.net, and I'm in my strawberry patch today. In Wisconsin, strawberries are almost as big as tomatoes. And if you're lucky enough to have strawberry plants, you know the joy of watching them as they're just starting out. They get their blossoms. Oops, this one just fell off. And then you start to see the green fruit, and you wait and wait, and then all of a sudden one day you've got red berries and you're ready. Now, when you're thinking of a size of strawberry patch that we have, which is about 10 feet by 20 feet, which is not that big, but it's bigger than a lot of people have space for. There are certain tools that you need to have ready. Bug spray, for one, especially if you're in Wisconsin. You need to have a kneeling pad, something you can put down under your knees to keep your pants dry, but also to protect your knees. You need something to put your berries in, which are old containers that I've saved up since winter. And then, because of my particular picking system that I make sure that I follow when I pick my strawberries, you need a bucket for weeds. You need a shovel to dig out the prickers and a glove to catch them with. Now, when I pick strawberries, I have three things I'm looking for. First of all, the berries. You want to pick berries that are ready. Now, this one's not quite ready, but you want to pick a berry that is red all around. Let me see if I can find one. Here we go. This one. But I'm also going to be picking this one, even though this one is not ready to eat today, because I don't want to be out here every single day. So I'll pick the berries that are ready today and the berries that will be ready tomorrow, and I'll keep them both. And then when I sort through them, when I'm getting them ready to preserve or to eat, I put those other berries, the ones that are not quite ready, in another container, and they'll sit on the kitchen counter for tomorrow, and then I'll have fresh berries again tomorrow. But the thing about picking berries is you want to look for the berries first. You want to find them and pick them. Here's a luscious, huge berry. But you also then want to take that stalk that the berry was on, if you can get in here to see, and you notice that they're going to be sitting on the ground. And that's exactly where those little sow and pill bugs and slugs and everything else want to get them. So I just kind of wrap them around some of the leaves so that they're not sitting on the ground anymore. Here's one sitting on the ground. I pick it up and just wrap it around a leaf. Now here's my third part. If you find a weed, you pull it out right away. And that's why you have your weed bucket with you, so you can toss it away. Just think, if you go through this garden patch once, twice, three times a week, and each time you're pulling out the weeds, there's going to be that much fewer weeds growing right in your patch. And then as the patch is done and you're not thinking about it for the rest of the year, you don't have all those weeds that are growing in here because you've taken care of it already. Now here you see three of them. I'll pick all three of these, even though this one is not quite ready to eat. It'll be ready tomorrow. Wrap it around. Move on to the next. I can spend about an hour a day just picking strawberries and making sure that I have wrapped them up and pulled all the weeds possible. But it's worth it. The flavor of these strawberries is like nothing you could ever buy in a store. They are so flavorful and they're so tender that, I mean, they just beg to be eaten.
And in wintertime?
In wintertime, you can freeze them whole like this. They'll be a little softer, obviously, when you thaw them out, but there's nothing like it. You'll never get it in a store. The job now is to take the stems off and also to take out the ones that aren't quite ready. Because if you'll remember, I pick for today and tomorrow. So what I'm doing is sorting through. You know, for years, I used a knife to take off the greenery. It is just this very year, I figured it's faster and easier to do it with my fingernail. And it's just a little twist and it's done. And I don't have to look for any knife. I don't have to pick up a knife and waste that extra energy. Now, you may not have a garden where you can pick your own strawberries, but there are times of the year when strawberries are on sale at the store. So you could go to the store and you could stock up on them. You could go to a farmer and pick your own strawberries. You might have a friend that has strawberry patch that will let you pick. So there's a number of ways that you can get strawberries if you don't have your own patch. Now, you can just eat so many strawberries. You would like to eat them all, but it's just impossible. So what you have to do is preserve them in some way. Some people like to make jam out of them. Some people just need to keep them for a day or two because you don't have that many. You may want to just put them in the refrigerator. What I'm doing now is I am preparing them for freezing. And there's different thoughts on freezing. You can freeze them whole, or you can crunch them down a little bit, put some sugar in, and freeze them in a plastic tin. So we'll go into that in just a minute as soon as I get through all of my berries. Okay, I'm back. I have just finished 18 pounds of strawberries that I picked today. Now, in the 18 pounds, remember, I picked for today and tomorrow. These were the ones that were not ready for today. So tomorrow I'll be going through these and again making selections if I need to, which are ripe and which aren't. This is the tops, or the damaged berries, or the ones that just didn't look good to me that I don't want to preserve and eat. So this will go on the compost pile. So we're going to recycle all those good green tops. Now, once I get them all washed and cleaned and selected, then you have to do something with these berries to preserve them. Now, you could take a cookie sheet, a plate, and just take the whole berry and put it on, put it in the freezer, and let them freeze solid in a single layer. Then take them off, put them in a plastic bag, and that way you will have whole strawberries to use whenever in the middle of winter. And while their texture will be a little bit different, they'll still be yummy and delicious. My family prefers when I put them with a little bit of sugar and make a sauce out of them. So that's what I'm going to show today. I have my berries here. I'm going to put a few more in here. Try not to spill them all over the floor. Okay, that's enough. I have a chopper that I'm going to use. You could use a potato masher. If you didn't have either one of these, you could just chop them up into tinier pieces. Then I take a scoop of sugar, and you see how many cups that is, maybe 3 cups of berries. And I'm going to add 1 scoop and a half a scoopy. This scoop is 1/4 cup. Then I'm just going to take my chopper and gently chop once around just to make them smaller. I don't want mush, but but I do want to bruise them so that some of the juice will come out, and then the sugar will draw the juice out even more. And you stir them up to make sure that the sugar gets on everything. Sugar is a preservative, so even if you were just going to eat these berries raw this way, if you have strawberries, you're not quite ready to eat them, there's too many of them, you want to preserve them, you can add some sugar to them, mush them up a little bit, add some sugar, and it will make them last longer even in the refrigerator. Okay, then I'm going to dump them into my clean plastic containers. We got these at the dollar store. You want to wash them when you bring them home. You don't want to just use them straight out of the package. And you're going to dump in your berries. And you don't want to fill it all the way to the top. My husband came in and said, "You're not filling them all the way to the top." And I said, "No, because you have to leave room for expansion. When these freeze, they're going to expand a little bit like water in a bottle. So you have to leave a little bit of expansion room." Put the cover on. Make sure it's sealed all the way. You can see the luscious berries right through. And then these will go in the freezer. There we go. Got that last one done. Now this will be my first batch going down into the freezer. Tomorrow I'll work on the other batch of the ones that weren't quite ready. And so I'll just put them all on the tray and carry them down to the freezer. And during the winter, I'll remember this day when my back was hurting and I was tired, but I'm happy that it's done. Now I've been picking strawberries for 2 weeks. I think I've picked, what do we say, Rick?
Well, I think you were over 56 pounds.
56 and then I don't know pounds, what. And then yesterday I picked, I think, 11 pounds. So I've picked a lot, and I have frozen a lot, and I have put them in my freezer. The whole top shelf of my freezer is now frozen strawberries, which we're really looking forward to. But we had no more space in that refrigerator, or that freezer at the moment, so I got the idea that I should be drying some of the strawberries. So last night, after I had cleaned and washed and taken care of my strawberries, I sliced them so that they were 3/8 of an inch thick. And when I started, this whole tray was bumper to bumper strawberries. There was no space in between. So you can see that they have really shrunken down. They have dried now for about 12 hours and they are now ready to come off of there and go into the bottle for winter. You know, that's like gold. Okay, so what you have to do now is just peel them off. Now this food dryer I have had for several years. I think we bought it at Target or Farm and Fleet or any place that has small food appliances. And all it is a little fan and a heater. And you can leave it on overnight while you're sleeping. If you go to work in the morning, just leave it on. And then be sure to store them in a dry place. So I'm putting them in a canning jar. I will put the cover on tightly. And then they will last throughout the winter. And whenever you get hungry, you can just go in there and eat some strawberry gold. Now another thing, not all the strawberries are big and luscious. So what I'm going to do with this other batch here is I'm going to make a fruit leather, strawberry fruit leather. And in order to do that, you need some way of mashing them up. I suppose you could do it with a potato masher. I'm going to use my food grinder here. Just going to dump some in. Now these are all clean, washed. Check for bugs. I'm going to put about half of these in here. Now I've not done this before, so this is an experiment for me. Then the book said to put some honey in.
What
not
book?
Sugar. Not sugar, because sugar will granulize when you're drying this. It's the little food book, the little recipe book that came with the dryer. It explained. Now, you could add other things to this. You could add some lemon, you could add papaya, you could add mangoes. But since I have an abundance of strawberries, I'm going to do strawberries. It also said not to use too much honey because, remember, when you're drying this, it's going to like compact everything and it'll be super sweet if you use too much. So I'm just going to put the cover on. Hold your ears. Doesn't take much for strawberries. Now I have a thin strawberry juice. Smells wonderful. Do you want to smell? The food dryer came with these plastic sheets. This is for fruit leather. And you're supposed to put it on so that it's about a quarter of an inch thick. I'm just going to guess. Smells great. Jiggle it around a little bit. Okay, now that will go onto one of the drying trays. This will be tricky. Should have done this before. Ooh, there we go. Not bad. And then that goes into the food dryer for 6 to 10 hours. So that'll be another overnighter kind of thing. We'll have to let you know how this one turns out. Twelve hours later, I'm about to take my fruit leather out of the dryer. So let's see how it did. It smells good. Oh, and it looks good. You can see that it's gotten leathery. It looks rather like the crater of Mars, the surface of Mars. But let's see how it comes off of this. Now, I didn't put anything down to keep it from sticking, so let's see how easily it pops off. There's a little resistance. And I noticed that this one seems to have cracks in it, so I think it could have been a little thicker. Now, to preserve this so that it lasts, unless you have kids and it disappears before you even get it stored, you need to cut it into little rolls. And then you need to roll those so they don't stick to it, doesn't stick to itself. You need to roll it up in wax paper or plastic wrap. Then what you're going to do is you're going to take these, I'm going to twist the ends on it so it looks like saltwater taffy. And you will store it in an airtight container, either a canning jar or plastic covered container, and then it can just stay at room temperature. You can put it in the closet, or in your cupboard. You could store them in the refrigerator if you like to have cold fruit roll-ups, but that's what you've made. You've made your own fruit roll-ups. You know what's in it. Strawberries, a little honey. That's it. How more healthful could that be?
Now, could you freeze them?
You could freeze them, sure. In fact,
and would that deteriorate, the strawberries over time? Or
no, well, you
want to
eat anything that you've frozen within a year.
Oh, okay.
I mean, they will last longer. They'll last indefinitely, but the quality of the food and the taste and the color will...
Could I have a little taste test?
Yes, you may.
Thank you. Kind of like a sweet beef jerky.
And you would be able to do this with any fruit that's kind of mushy, like peaches or raspberries. Raspberries will have the seeds in them, but that's okay. Any soft fruit.
Blueberries. Pineapple?
I suppose you could. You'd have to experiment.
And
that's
a mix?
The fun of it. Definitely a mix, a blend. Mangoes and papayas and... even grapes, I suppose. Anything that's easily chopped up by a fruit food processor. Let me try one. The flavor is intense.
Yes, it is.
Much better than a fruit roll-up. Different, a little bit different texture, but your kids will like it. Bye for now. I hope there's some left.